We left with the table of natural log of x and log of x. So most of the time when I mean log of x, I mean I'm talking about base 10. So there is one equation which the book talks about. It is the production function which has two exponential for labor and capital. So when we want to play around with this equation, we might require the help of log. So we'll take log on both sides and separate things, and then we would be able to solve this. So moving back to the book, it talks about how the money would grow when we have annual, quarterly, and monthly compounding, and gives us a rate. So in most of the question where it will say that when the money would double or when the money would triple, we would require this equation. And now we will look at some of the graphs which they have made. So in the initial part, we were looking at different graphs. So graph for y equal to 2 to the power x, 3 to the power x, 4 to the power x. So as we can expect, as we increase from 2 to 4, the speed would change very rapidly. And that's how where we see. So y is equal to 4 to the power x goes more steep, and y equal to 3 to the power x, and so on. And likewise, they have the graph for minus x. So minus x is nothing but you are increasing half by x, so it will become smaller and smaller as you increase the numbers. So it's a half to the power 1, half to the power 2, half to the power 3, half to the power 4, and so on. And as you keep on going, it goes very close to zero. Exponential, for now, you can assume is a fixed value of 2.7, and from there they are punching in the values to get to a particular number. Now, exponential and log both are mirror images of one another, because that's just a way to transform and put a different look at the same equation. So in figure 11.8, they say that if you have e to the power x, which means that an exponentially increasing chart, then log x would be something which is decreasing, or the rate of increase is decreasing at each time. So it's like stopping when it goes up. Now, the sample questions that they have given here is solving and searching for the number. So whenever you see something like log 49 base 7, this would mean that you are asking 7 to the power of what is 49, and the answer becomes 2. Or you can write the same equation in the exponential format, where you'll take the base, and the thing that you have on the right hand side, you'll take that as power, and you'll equal that to what you have inside the log. Then there are some questions on properties of log. Now, there is one interesting thing about the exponential function which will come again with us. So if we draw the exponential function, it's a very rapidly increasing function, and at x equal to 0, e to the power x is 1. At x equal to 1, this is like 2.7. When x equal to 2, this is like 2.7 to the power 2, something like 8, something like here, and so on. So when we integrate this, we get e to the power x, which means that if we take out the values and if we take this area under curve, we will get the area which is equal to this height. So we'll look at this again in the next chapter, but since they are using that here, the differentiation, so I'm just repeating that. And then we have interest compounding. Okay, I think that was it. In case you have any doubt, you can post me back.